Okay guys, so welcome back to the channel. Thought I'd just bring you up to speed with what's been going on here at the house with the new reef tank build. So what strange times we are living at the moment, what with all the lockdown. I've got the wife off work, my daughter's back from college, and obviously my son is off school as well. So the house has been really busy. Lots of noise and stuff, so it's been quite hard to get these videos out. But rest assured, I am going to persevere and try and get a video out every week for you guys, just to sort of show you my journey with building this new tank and on different subjects on it. So lighting, so going back to the Red Sea Max Nano, I've actually sold the tank now. Initially I had someone lined up that wanted it, been waiting around for months for her to collect it, and she let me down at the last minute. So that's really annoying. What I had to do is chuck it onto eBay. I don't know if a lot of you guys might have seen it onto eBay. And luckily I had a buyer come along, and he's obviously not collecting it for a few weeks till we're out of lockdown. But it's released some funds for me to get on with building the new one. And obviously the first thing I had to get on is the lights, or decide what lights I'm going for, and start getting some lighting above the tank for all the livestock that's been transferred. So my initial plan was to go with the new Red Sea Reef LED 90s, and I made a complete U-turn with the decision on that and thought, do you know what, I'm going to go back with what I know grows coral, and you know, I've had great success with previously, especially my Reefer 250. The Red Sea lights are nice, and my son's having good success with them, and they do look really good. Just say there's a few issues. Don't like the mounting options for them. I just don't like that mounting arm at all. And the main reason is I don't like the Wi-Fi connectivity and the controllability for an app through your phone. I'm a bit old school. I don't like app-controlled equipment. It's connectivity issues, especially with the Red Sea lights at the moment. As good as they are, there are issues with connectivity, and they are updating their firmware, you know, regularly. But it's just a pain, really. So I love the spectral controller that Kessil offer. You had a dedicated controller, set and forget. I don't need it to be Wi-Fi controlled. Say I'm at the house a lot, so a nice controller for the lights is perfectly adequate for my needs. So choices wise with the going Kessil, simple really. The new awesome 360X units, beautiful little units. They're small footprint, just love the aesthetical look of the lights. And like I say before, I've had really good success before, so no doubt they'll grow coral really well. But the trouble is, obviously, with me being self-employed, work is slow at the moment, so we don't have as many pennies kicking around. So we've only purchased one to start with, and obviously, fingers crossed, there's going to be just enough par to keep the corals happy till I've got enough funds in the next few weeks to put another unit on the tank. So I'm going to run two units. So this is the unboxing of the 360X. So they're quite expensive, like £475 odd, and that's without the mounting arm. That's another £65, and obviously spectral controllers £130 on top. So that's the last thing we've put on, is the spectral controllers. So we get the lights first. So this initially first unit to go onto the tank. Like I say, it's been quite hard money wise to get things together, but we're doing it bit by bit. So over the next few months, we should have every piece of equipment we need to run the tank. So mounting options for the 360X, they do the 90 degree arm, which is just an awesome mounting arm. What's good about it over the Red Sea mounting arms is that it's not only height adjustable, it's rake adjustable as well. So you can adjust it to position over the top of the tank, wherever you want, whatever height you want. I like to run my lights a little bit lower to the water surface than the sort of preset arms that are sort of 8, 9, 10 inches. Say I like to run around 6 inches. So, yeah, another reason why I love these Kessil lights and mounting arms. So you've purchased the 90 degree arm. There it is on the tank. Just looks awesome. really nice, low profile, hides the cable nicely inside the tube. So the units themselves aesthetically look really nice with the Kessil branding there on the front, and it's also on the arm as well, Kessil branding on the arm. Obviously, because I haven't got the spectral control, I'm going to have to twiddle these knobs on top. But what's really good is that with Kessil logic, it doesn't matter where you have the colour knob on the left. You just set that to whatever you want to aesthetically look good, and the spectrum will be perfect for the coral steel. So anyway, I'm going to wrap the video up. I'm not going to show you inside the tank just yet. That'll be in the next video. Say hit that like if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe, and that bell, say hitting the like really helps me out, guys. And also check my son's channel out, it's Corey Willard on YouTube. So thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.